When it comes to a great vlog series for people of all ages, you can count on Brian Mullins the Fox. Storytelling never looks so good. With vices that look even better, Brian Mullins the Fox means Vlog Entertainment. Hello everybody, I am Brian Mullins the Fox, and welcome to Episode 8 of the Adventurous Mischiefs in a Post-Detective World. Here is the story of how the very old, white and blue, dysfunctional water heater had a huge meltdown and flooded my entire laundry room. This happened a few months after the old water heater caused the circuit breaker to trip more than once, probably 3, 4, if not 5 times. Prior to its meltdown, my dad went to work back in 2019. When he did, a few hours later, when I was asleep, I noticed that I heard dripping. When I woke up, I heard lots of dripping. And then I noticed a good portion of the carpet around there is wet. And I walked into the laundry room. It was roughly an inch of that old water heater water just flooding. There were a few towels that were surrounding it. And I guess it did nothing to stop the leaking until maintenance came around and turned off the water in our fucking apartment. And for a month or so, we had no running water. So every time we went to Walmart, we had to get these gallons and gallons of water. It was at this point in 2019 that we couldn't be able to flush the toilet more than once for days. We were drinking water bottles still, but we had to rely on the giant water jugs that were about a gallon each to help flush our toilets, to help with whatever the hell we need it for, such as washing our hands. Our maintenance man came back with an alternative, similar-looking water heater that was still somewhat functional, and that was only there for a few more months, up until May/June, when we officially had our old water heater replaced with a new, much larger, 48-gallon water heater. It was a dark gray one instead of white and blue. After it was installed, the people who installed it sort of left a tiny hole or two in the wall, but that's okay, it doesn't matter. As long as we have a new water heater back then nothing really matters at this point. So far, we had that relatively new water heater for over 2 years now. So I guess it has another decade or so left of its life. Now keep in mind, that wasn't the only maintenance issue we had in 2019, because a few months after that, we had issues with the bathtub faucet that couldn't release any water from the main spout. So my dad had to give his all to this thing. And when water finally came out, all he did was pull up the shower tab. And then the entire bathtub spout flew out. And then my dad had to walk out of the bathroom, walk his bare naked ass alongside with me while I had clothes on to shut off the water until this problem was solved. So just the morning after all this shit went down, the maintenance crew, just like the ones that helped install our new water heater the same year, a few months prior, helped replace our shower/bathtub faucet and temperature control. And now, after roughly 2 years after the fact, every time me or my dad takes a shower, turning on the water and turning it off, changing the temperature is a whole lot easier than it ever was before, even before I came here. Even when I was new here in this old apartment back in 2017, the valve to turn the water on and off in the bathtub/shower was having difficulties turning on. It was a pain in the ass for me to get water out of that fucking spout, and now it's a whole lot easier. Anything outside of this, years later, we only had to deal with a few merely minor maintenance issues, such as the old refrigerator we have having a colossal meltdown and almost flooding a good part of my kitchen, mainly a fifth or if not a tenth of it. And when it was drained out, it was performing a lot better, and I'm worried that this year, in November, its warranty will expire, and who knows what'll happen after that. Maybe a bigger meltdown will happen, or the fridge will just completely stop functioning in its entirety. Well, that's the end of this very final... Well, that'll do it for the very last storytime segment of the Adventurous Mischiefs in a Post-Detective World, or Episode 8. I am Brian Mullins the Fox, signing out. Have a good day, everybody.
Nicky, says the law, the leap for fierce valley, we're losing my kennel.